Welcome back to another episode of This Week on Channel 9. I'm your host, Christina Warren, Senior Cloud Advocate, and you might notice that we are not in the studio and I am not in front of a green screen. That's right, we are in Amsterdam for Microsoft Ignite, the tour, and I've had an amazing 2 days getting to know the fantastic Amsterdam dev community. Thousands of people are here and everyone is so nice. I should also point out that I'm wearing my retro Microsoft sweatshirt that I successfully purchased that I mentioned on last week's show. So let's get into this week's dev news. So first up, speaking of Microsoft Ignite, the tour, we've still got a few more stops left on this year's tour. We'll be in Dubai, Stockholm, Mexico City, and Mumbai. And details about the events are in a link in the description down below, and we would love to see you there. And as always, if you see me at any of these events, please say hello. And speaking of events, we've got a few other ones I want to talk about. So first up, Microsoft Build is taking place May 6th through 8th, 2019 at the Washington State Convention Center in Seattle. And this is our annual dev conference, and there's going to be tons of news and updates and awesome people, so you don't want to miss this. I will be there along with the Channel 9 crew, and we would love to see you there as well. And finally, for all the startups out there, we've got a brand new startup event series called Create that will be taking place in cities around the world, including New York and London and Toronto and Berlin and San Francisco and Tel Aviv and more. And so Create's going to have technical and business content aimed at helping startups scale their businesses and learn more about things like security and containers and serverless and Kubernetes and AI and governance and all kinds of other great stuff. So I'm going to be at some of the stops, and this is going to be an awesome event. So if you've got a startup and you're looking for more insight on how to grow and check out the various things, go to createstartups.io for all the details, and links are in the show notes down below. In some super exciting product news, the Windows Virtual Desktop on Azure is now in public preview. And so this was announced last year, and it offers a way for businesses and devs to deploy and scale their Windows desktops, as well as their apps, onto Azure in minutes. And you can also do this while enjoying built-in security and compliance. And so this means the customers can virtualize using like multi-session Windows 10 and Windows 7 and Windows Server desktops and apps using RDS to Windows Virtual Desktop in a simplified way. It makes it easy to deploy with Azure. So I've got a link for more info in the show notes and description, but this is a great way to be able to deploy Windows 10 machines in the cloud so that you can access all your apps or tools or whatever from any device. And speaking of new products, Azure DevOps Server 2019 is out now. And so this was previously known as TFS, but Azure DevOps Server 2019 basically brings all the power of Azure DevOps, but to your dedicated environment. And details are in the show notes down below. For .NET Core devs, the .NET Core container images are being published now by Microsoft in the Microsoft Container Registry. And so there's a link in the show notes down below to a blog post from Rich Lander explaining the change. But the main reasons for the images going to MCR are that this will let the team basically establish MCR as the official source for all Microsoft-provided container images. And then they'll be able to more easily promote and syndicate those images to other container services like Docker Hub or Red Hat OpenShift. And so this is also going to let the team use Azure as its CDN when distributing those images, which should hopefully make things faster in many cases. And so the Docker Hub repo pages are going to continue to work and will be supported and updated with the latest info, and existing images will be maintained. But starting with .NET Core 3.0, MCR is going to be the only places the images will be published. Now, like I said, those images will still be syndicated to Docker Hub, but you're going to need to update your from statements in Dockerfile files and Docker pull commands to point to the new location. Like I said, there is a blog post with more information, and that's linked down below. And this is actually a really nice segue into a fantastic blog post from Aaron Powell that's an introduction into ACI, or Azure Container Instances, and that's one of the easiest ways to run containers in the cloud. In some serverless news, Simona Cotin, one of my favorite people in the world, has a great post for CSS Tricks about 7 things you should know when getting started with serverless APIs. And so the post is super in-depth, and it covers things like how to create a new serverless project, how to debug code locally, how to install dependencies, and ultimately how to deploy to the cloud. And so once you're at that stage, Dean Bryan has a great post on Azure Functions, which is a great serverless platform, offering a developer's guide to all of its key features. So it's GDC, aka the Game Developer Conference, this week, and the Azure team announced Microsoft GameStack. And so GameStack is awesome because it brings together all of our game development platforms, tools, and services like Azure, PlayFab, DirectX, Visual Studio, Xbox Live, App Center, and more into like a robust ecosystem that any game developer can use. And so the goal of GameStack is basically to help you discover what tools and services you need to create and operate your game. And so I've got links down below for blog posts diving into what it is, how it works, and how you can use it for your games and projects. And this is a really good segue to what video content we've got on Channel 9 this week. So first up on on.net, Cecil and Brian Peek talk about building games with MonoGame. And over on FiveThings, Burke and Noel talk about five ways you can infuse AI into your apps. And on the IoT show, Olivier and John Sheehan are talking about the impact that IoT is having on Azure. And now it's time for my pick of the week. So this actually happened a couple weeks ago, but due to travel, I wasn't able to record. And so this was too cool for me to pass up. The Windows team open sourced Windows Calculator, and that app is now on GitHub under the MIT license. And like, this is supremely cool because it's not just the source code, it's also the unit tests, the build system, and even the product roadmap. And so devs can integrate the calculator logic or its UI into their own projects. And what's super cool is that this is a real-world example that any dev can use to learn more about things like XAML or UWP or Fluent Design. And obviously, PRs are welcome. And like, this isn't just, like I said, it's not just dumping the code. The team's roadmap is public too. And suggestions and modifications and discussions are all welcome and will find its way into the final shipping product. I love open source. And I love Amsterdam. So this does it for me. If you liked this video, go ahead and leave a like on it. And if you're on YouTube, go ahead and subscribe to us at Microsoft Developer for all the latest dev content. And let me know in the comments some of your favorite new tools for VS Code, whether there's extensions or other things you're finding out, because it's spring and like I want to do a blog or a video on some of the best stuff out there. See you next week.